Okay, good evening everyone, and today video I'm going to show you how to connect the Samsung SmartThings app to my Samsung Smart TV. As now I already connect the TV with the app. After I roughly show you the function of the app, I will uninstall the app and then we will try to download the app and reconnect all together. Okay, now let's begin. Okay, first of all, you can see the ThinQ app is a SmartThings app is already installed in my phone. You can see here this app. It's called SmartThings. Okay, you just press it on. And now I will show you some function. And please make sure that this app can control your TV only when your TV is already turning on. After you turn off the TV, so you cannot turn on by this app. You just need to turn it on by your remote control. And now we go to the TV. First of all, I show you the this shortcut, this is what I like. So we can press the source and app. So you can make change to the live TV and remote access. Remote access, so now the TV is turned to the remote access. And then you can press on YouTube app and then it go to YouTube gallery. So you no need to press any button on your TV. Okay, I need to sign in, so just roughly, so we go to the Netflix and then the TV is go to the Netflix or e-menu. So it very fast, we no need to press on the remote control, exit and go one by one. So I now open the game that I already download to the TV. So now it's loading. And then just press back to the live TV. And it will go back to the live TV. Okay, another thing, you can remote it just like the normal remote control on the TV. So this shortcut, you can press the volume up and volume down. So when we press and hold, so you can see the volume is increased on and on. And when you scroll it back to the left, and then you can see the now the volume is turning back to the right again and increase the volume, and you also can mod the volume here. Okay, and now we go direct to the remote, and now we have some other function. So we can have the four pads. This one we can just like the arrow of the remote control, and then I press the home button first, and then we press the arrows down. You can see on the TV, press the right key, and then it's go to another application. And then if you want to select, just press on the touchpad, and now it go to the YouTube. Okay, and here is a channel changing for live TV, and here is the number of the, we can select any channel and another option. So I normally use only the four pad, and then here we cannot have the mouse pad on here, but we can control like this. But if you want to have the mouse pad, we need to go back to the, you can press the right and just scroll right and left so you can see the manual is changing, and get back to the mouse pad. If you want to get the mouse pad, you need to go to the internet and then select, and now you try to scroll. Wait a minute. Okay, you can see the mouse pad is on the TV screen. So the mouse can use only when it going to the browser of the internet. Okay, and that's all for the program solving. So now I try to let you know how to connect the app to your TV. Okay, first of all, I need to uninstall the application first.
So now you go to the store and then write the word SmartThings. No space, just all the way. Just all the text, no space for the SmartThings. SmartThings. And then you see this application look like a snow.
So you just install it. Okay, now after I already installed the app on my phone, now we try to open it together. Okay, and then you just skip or need to go through the instruction of the app one by one. And finally, you just press the start. And now it asks you to confirm your location. Just continue and allow to turn on the location. And now you need to sign in. Just press the word sign in. And you just continue with your Google account that you already signed in your phone. Press any email of your Gmail. Okay, then you just press the continue. And now you already signed in into the app. Just press this Okay, because I used to set up the TV with this app, so now it already have the TV. So now I will delete the device and then reconnect it again. Okay, you just press the word device and then press hold it on and press edit. And now I delete device, press the delete device and then delete. Okay, at the first time you need to scan for your TV. Just press the word device. Okay, now you just press add device and then you need to press the word scans nearby here. And then you need to turn the Bluetooth on. So it just requests you to turn on the Bluetooth. And now it's scanning. Okay, and turn on the location. Then get back to the app. So now it's scanning for the TV. And now you can see your TV is display on the screen now. Please make sure that the phone and the TV are connected to the same Wi-Fi network. Just press on the TV's name. And now you can start connecting. Just press the word start. And now it connects to the phone. And now it's connecting together and continue with your Gmail. Okay, now it's registering. You can now make change your TV's name. Okay, for example, I want to
make change Samsung TV 32 inch. Okay, just press tick.
Also, you can add it, set it as your favorite, and then just tick. And now you already, and now you can see the Samsung TV on the living room. So you can add more room or any adjustment as you want, for example, living room, kitchen, or another bedroom. Okay, so now let's skip the adjustment. We go direct to the favorite. And then you can now select on the TV. And now it's connect to the app like I show you at the first of the video. Okay, now I press to the YouTube and then it back to the YouTube app. Live TV. So all the function I already explained you at the beginning of the video, so I no need to explain once more time. Okay, I think that's all for today video of how you can connect the SmartThings app to your Samsung Smart TV. And thank you everyone for your time watching this video. And I hope you can connect it successfully. That's all for today. I hope to see you again in the next video. Bye bye and have a nice day.